think my first memory would be my father taking me to a Christmas party at his work, because that was the first time I saw Santa.
Well, my first memory of Christmas is seeing a big tree and a lot of presents under the trees, and knowing that majority of those presents was mine.
My first memory at Christmas is from when I was about 3 or 4 years old. I remember waking up Christmas morning, we had a huge tree, at least it seemed big, and there were presents all under the tree. That was just so exciting because I just don't remember ever seeing that before. When everyone had presents and we had family over, and I just remember everyone opening presents and laughing, and we just had a really good time.
I was 7 years old and I was with my grandparents and all my family from everywhere, Canada, different parts of Jamaica, America, everyone came just to celebrate Christmas that day. It was the warmest Christmas though. And everybody was cooking and we were laughing, having a great time. So that was my first memory.
So my first memory of Christmas was actually when I learned that Santa was not real. I heard something outside my room, and when I went to look, I saw the silhouettes of my mother and father carrying gifts from their bedroom and putting them under the tree. That was actually my first memory.
I can very much remember I had the old black and white Game Boy, and I got Super Mario Land. And there's a video of me going, "Whoa!" when I got it. So I was very excited for it.
Money. My dad would just give us money. There was no like official gifts, you know, back then. So I remember just getting, I used some money like for a small kid, you know? Yeah, I was like, oh, this is kind of cool.
My most memorable Christmas gift would have to be when my parents bought me my first car.
When I got my first horse, and I was 6, so my dad took me outside and I thought it was a reindeer, so I cried.
My little brother, he's in the military, so we haven't seen him for like 4 years. And then he surprised us on Christmas Day. Yeah, so that was the most memorable Christmas gift.
I don't remember how old I was, but I remember I really, really wanted a bike really bad, and I went to sleep and there was no bike there. There were no presents there. We didn't have a lot of money, so I didn't expect a whole lot. And then I remember my sister shaking me awake, like I thought there was an earthquake or something in Texas. It was weird. And I ran downstairs and there was a bike, and that was the earliest Mom was cooking. And
the first Christmas gift I remember was a Justin Timberlake CD that I really wanted, and I got it.
Okay, the most memorable one is as an adult, and it was from a friend who actually got me the match program from my first football match framed. I thought that was really good, and also shows that it doesn't have to be expensive, it just has to mean something.
My most memorable gift, and I still have it, it was from about 13 years ago. I actually had a workshop to do on a Saturday, because I was a teacher, and a friend of mine took my kids for the day, and I didn't know, but she took them to a pottery store, and they actually made a bowl, and then they decorated it. They put horizontal straps on the outside and vertical straps on the inside, and they put their names on the bottom, and they gave that to me for Christmas, and I love it. I still have it.
Yeah, so my family tradition, we actually open most of our gifts on Christmas Eve, and we leave the biggest one for Christmas morning. It was just a family tradition my parents did, my mother did with her family, so we carried it on. But now that I am a father, I am hoping to start a lot more Christmas traditions with my son and my wife.
Yes. Christmas, we always make Christmas cake. It's kind of like fruit cake with rum, and it's black cake, and you always drink it with sorrel. And in our tradition, if somebody gives you sorrel, then that means you are special. Yeah, it's a special moment.
Not more special than other Aussies. A lot of us do a barbecue. So as you'd expect, we have a barbie. And we put all the grilled meats on there, have a good time. Get our snags, put some tomato sauce on there, have a bite. It's good stuff.
Because we run a wholesale business back home, so we sell like beverages and food and stuff. So every morning, very early in the morning, we wake up and then we go to the business to open for the people to buy, you know, for the Christmas day. So every day, every Christmas we do that, and then we close at like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, and then we go to our family lunch, and then from there everybody can go wherever they want to go. But it always starts like that. We have to open the store and sell to the people, and then go to the lunch, and then everybody goes back. So where they, yeah.
We celebrate St. Stephen's Day instead of Boxing Day, which is lots of singing and dancing at carol services at chapel.
As much as anything, what was important, as well as Christmas, just opening the presents, watching TV all day. The important thing for us was the day after, because in the UK we have Boxing Day as well. And Boxing Day is always football day. We'd always go to football as a family.
I would think our special tradition is after Christmas lunch, we would go outside our front yard. My dad will set up the gazebo and we would like play music and play dominoes. And I think that's the tradition, because all the family gathers under the gazebo, kids, whatever, adults, and just chill.
We do. We go to church Christmas Eve, and then we come home, we eat regular dinner, nothing fancy, and then we stay up till midnight watching Polar Express with hot chocolate. My mom tried eggnog 1 year, it was not great. And at midnight we open our stockings, and then we go to bed, and then we get to wake up, then we have to go to church again, and we have to wait all morning to open our presents, and then we get to open them. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Thank you.